So an example for this would be maybe a video you can say for YouTube. It would be like, oh wow, Salman Khan and Aishwarya, are they back together, right? And then we'd be like, oh wow, are you serious? Are they? Maybe they're coming in a movie together or something. We click on the video and what happens? They'll be like, oh yeah, they were together at the IFA Awards. We'll be like, ah, we totally didn't expect this. Out of the title. So clickbaits are deceiving titles. So they are kind of tricks to make people watch the video, to make people enter your website. Now tell me, why do you think people would do this? People would generally do this because to get quick traffic onto their website or to get quick views, more number of views. So in the long run, immediately it may kind of pay off, but in the long run, the people who have already been deceived by these kind of videos and blogs in the future would not want to visit your website again or would not want to watch videos from your blog, your YouTube channel again. So again, it depends on how you think it is fair enough to be used or not. But otherwise, it is an unethical practice because in the long run, we need to make sure that we kind of maintain a good relationship, a virtual relationship with our readers and our audience because we want them to get back and grasp more content from our end. Okay, so a few of the content marketing strategies we will talk about. The content marketing strategies, the first thing is you need to have a good recall value of your name. Or when you're opening up a website, you need to make sure that it has a good recall value. Unlike, see Amazon and they may have a good recall value and stuff. It's because even if they, however hard or tongue-twisting their name would have been, people would have still remembered them because that's how they are. That's how big they are in the market. But talking about a small-time bloggers, what we need to do is no, we cannot really spend that much, push our brand onto people's mind, right? So this is why the best practice is to have a good recall value of the name. Something like, Bewakoof.com, they came up with a very great recall value, and also now they are a lot into advertising, but they came up just a few years ago. And the main thing is, their tagline also which says to keep you insane because insanity unites us all. It's a very catchy name and it's a very catchy tagline, and it is especially very popular among the youngsters. Then another one is your Amul. So when it comes to Amul, what do you think? I'm sure right now the little girl is coming to your mind, the animated girl. But yes, apart from that, the way they go ahead and market their product and link everything to their product, the trending news, anything that's trending right now in the country, they make sure they work on that and they somehow try and link it to their product. And they are kind of the epitome in the way they market the new, in the way they market their product, linking the current news and the happenings of the country.